I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, once so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Good evening, Mr. Portis, Dr. Winning, Mr. Seborowski, Ms. Ringen, members of the Board of Education, Pequannock Administration, PV faculty and staff, parents, family members, and most importantly, the PV Class of 2020. It is with great honor and great pride that I deliver this speech to you all today. This day has been a long time coming for myself and for my peers as well. We all know that this isn't exactly how our sixth grade selves imagined our eighth grade graduation day to be, but I find it remarkable how we are still able to celebrate our 3 years of hard work and dedication today. I remember waking up bright and early on our first day of sixth grade in September 2017. I remember putting on the outfit that I'd spent hours picking out the night before. Today's the day, I thought, the day I dive into the world of middle school. It felt so strange to me to say that I was in middle school. My heart hadn't fully left elementary school yet. I remember my parents pulling up to PV to drop me off. I gazed in complete awe at the maze that was my new school. I got out of the car, trying to somewhat ease the knot of nervousness and excitement that had formed in my stomach. I entered the cafeteria and saw my classmates, whose faces were just as lost and awestruck as my own. I also remember the first time I saw the eighth graders. Those big, tall, scary eighth graders who were at least a foot taller and 50 pounds heavier than I was. At that moment, I didn't even realize that in a few short, and I mean very short years, I was going to be one of them. It wasn't even a thought in my mind, yet as sixth and seventh grade came and went in the blink of an eye, I became one of them. And as it turns out, eighth graders, no matter what class, will always be a foot taller than me. Regardless, my 3 years at PV happened, and it wasn't until my teachers addressed myself and my classmates as eighth graders on the first day of school that it hit me. It felt so strange to look back for just a minute and think of how quickly those 3 years went by. Ferris Bueller said, "Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it." And if you think about it, he's right. It's strange to think that at first, my only worries were whether I was going to have to see the eighth graders in the hallway or have to participate in gym class with them. If someone from the future were to tell me that my graduation was going to be online, I would have said, "You're crazy." But sure enough, that crazy became a reality very quickly. Just like that, we, not only as a state, but as a country, were submerged into uncharted waters. Buildings start closing, wearing a mask is now normal, and FaceTiming has become the only way to hang out with friends. Even so, there is a semblance of beauty in this time of uncertainty. That beauty is hope. Hope that we will all be together soon. That hope is what keeps us going every day. In fact, that same hope is the very reason we are graduating virtually. By doing this now, we have hope that we'll be together later.
Good evening, Pequannock Township School District community members. I am honored to be here to address the PV class of 2020. Back in June 2019, Mr. Hazel was your principal, Mr. Seborowski was your assistant principal, and none of you knew that I'd end up being your superintendent. I didn't even know I was going to end up being your superintendent. If I had said COVID in public somewhere, someone would have politely translated that my Boston accent had returned and I had just butchered the word covert. And truthfully, none of us had any inclination or idea that our nation would be closely examining our national identity. Yet here we are in June of 2020 in a world that defies prediction and one that confirms the truth of a song lyric that I treasured when I was in high school. Changes aren't permanent, but change is. So much has changed for you since you began middle school. Think back to who you were in fifth grade. You probably thought you were a pretty big deal, the leaders of your elementary schools. And then you started sixth grade and had to reevaluate that identity. But now, once again, you are the proverbial big deal, the leaders of your middle school. You have asserted yourselves at PV as artists, musicians, athletes, advocates, scholars, and more. You have been recognized, received honors, and literally been crowned champions. And soon enough, you'll be the new kids at the high school. The change from middle school to high school is a significant one, and it shouldn't intimidate you. Not one of you. It helps that you have Mr. Hazler at PTHS waiting to welcome you. But on a deeper level, think of how you've grown, and more specifically over the past 3 months, how you've adapted and responded to incredible change. I do not speak from experience, but if you want to build muscle, you don't work out with 2-pound hand weights. No, you work with the heaviest weight you can manage and gradually add more as you grow. That's how you build strength. You, my friends, jumped ahead several weight classes very quickly and showed that you could handle it. There's an adage that every day you're getting better or worse, but you never stay the same. You have demonstrated the ability to get better, and with the support of an incredible staff and community, have exceeded our expectations and become significantly better. In 1899, the head of the U.S. Patent Service recommended closing the Bureau because everything worth inventing had already been invented. His lack of vision is laughable now, but reflects a notion that we can freeze a moment in time, that we can climb a summit and just hang out at the peak. Life doesn't work that way, nor do we necessarily want it to. Change is unsettling. It can be scary, and it is often involuntary, but it is also exciting and eye-opening and meaningful. Change can also be controlled to some extent by willful, confident, daring, and courageous people. Our goal as a school district is to help to cultivate those traits in all our students and help build the skills and confidence for each of you to march forth to shape the changes you want to see in your world. Our world, really. I can't pretend to know what our world will look like when you graduate high school in 4 years, and frankly, I don't even know what to expect in September. But I do know this, it will be different. Maybe better, maybe worse, definitely different. It'll change. None of us really knows exactly how, but you, my class of 2020, you have the power to shape some of that change. You can do it. You will do it. You've got this. We've got this. Best of luck, and let's keep being great together. Thank you.
Good evening, Mr. Portis, Dr. Winning, Mrs. McCarty, members of the Board of Education, Ms. Ringen, Mr. Hazler, Pequannock Administration, Pequannock Valley School faculty and staff, family, friends, and most importantly, the PV class of 2020. When we sat together in the PV gym for your sixth grade orientation in August of 2017, one of the things I said to you was that your middle school years will be an interesting, challenging, and if you give your best effort, a fulfilling journey. Little did we know just how challenging the final stages of the journey would be. But as the great John Wooden once said, things turn out the best for the people who make the best of the way things turn out. As I give this speech before an empty auditorium, I am reminded just how difficult this journey has been for all of us. At the same time, though, my experiences in being one of many who put tonight's program together has also filled me with a great deal of pride. In a few minutes, everyone will meet our graduates and hear their names. In working with our 8th grade students to put these slides together, I was reminded just how successful this group of young men and women are. You are scholars. You are athletes. You are musicians. You are performers. You are inventors. You are creators. You are leaders. And what do you get when you put all of that together? You get the answer to a question you have heard many times, and that question is, who are we? In these last 3 months, the answer has never been clearer. We are PV. Over these last few months, I have learned that, yes, in name, PV is a place and building that many of us love, but PV isn't just a building. It is an idea, a philosophy, a culture that every single one of our students, staff members, and parents helped to create during our 3 years together. PV is the student who, when in the building, may not know exactly where they fit in at times, but are quick to reach out to a peer who might be in need of help in the cafeteria. Or remotely, perhaps playing music together through Zoom sessions in order to stay in touch and be a calming presence for their peers. PV is the teacher who, when in the building, notices a student who might be upset and takes the time to sit and talk and put a smile on their face. Or remotely, just finishing grading 90 projects online, but checks their email before going to sleep to ensure they have done all they can today to help their students. PV is the counselor, child study team member, and nurse who, when in the building, assists their students in any way they need, or remotely by holding regular Google Meet sessions just to check in and talk. PV is the secretary who, when in the building, searches tirelessly for a student's missing Chromebook, or remotely by contacting parents regularly to make sure their child is okay. PV is the instructional aide who, when in the building, provides that extra bit of support in class, or remotely by being involved in a Zoom birthday party for their student. PV is the custodian who, when we are in the building, digs through a cafeteria garbage can looking for a student's retainer, or remotely by getting the building clean and ready for our return. PV is the parent who, when we are in the building, communicates with teachers to best assist their child, chaperones events, and assists in many behind-the-scenes ways, or remotely by giving their child and teachers constant words of encouragement and support. My point is, PV is not simply a building, but a spirit that resides in all of us. And yes, it has been disappointing to not be in the building together. I can certainly attest to that. But all of you have continued to display the PV spirit in the most challenging of times. An educator's greatest hope is that he is able to impart some form of knowledge to best assist students as they move forward. In turn, I learned a long time ago that the lessons our students teach us can be the greatest treasures we unearth in our careers. You, the class of 2020, have reinforced in me that the impossible can always become a reality, and I will take that with me as I move through my career. In the beginning of the year, when I was both the interim principal and assistant principal, I met with you and said I needed your help if we were all going to be successful with this transition. Of course, I also joked and said that if you don't want me as your principal, then I guess you really don't have to listen to me. Your support of me, though, during that time was instrumental in putting me in this position to speak to you tonight. When I lost my father in March, it was a difficult time, but there you were yet again, reaching out to me through emails, Google Hangouts, letters, and cards. That PV spirit that defined you was ever present and helped me in dealing with a difficult personal time in my life. And finally, during these last 3 months, your resolve in this transition speaks to your character, determination, and perseverance. Simply put, you demonstrated our motto of knowledge, spirit, promise on a daily basis, and I couldn't be more grateful for that. It is for these reasons the PV class of 2020 will always hold a special place in my heart. We have been together for 3 years and have certainly been through a lot together. As you get ready to move on to high school, I look forward to seeing all of your accomplishments. Please know, though, that the PV administration, teachers, and staff are just a phone call, email, or visit away. There is a saying the New York Giants use for players and coaches who move on from the team: once a Giant, always a Giant. Please know the same applies for all of you. Once a PV Panther, always a PV Panther. New and exciting challenges await you, but always know that familiar faces are here to help you in any way that we can. How do I know that, you might ask? Because when it comes down to it, I am reminded of the answer to a very simple question. We are PV. Thank you. It is now my honor to present to you the Pequannock Valley School graduating class of 2020. Dominic Ayosa. Kurt Albinson. Jacob Anderson. Molly Anger. Lauren Arnold. Kevin Barron. Stephanie Benevenia. Emily Bernstein. Karis Blakely. Sienna Bach. Julia Bonelli. James Bonner. Matthew Bulger. Kaylee Bunsen. Avery Calhoun. Thomas Cantisano. Colton Carfello. Isabella Castagna. Victoria Castaldo. Caden Chase. Azaria Clay. Olivia Conacenti. Josie Corsi. Selena Crassion. Nathaniel Krefeld. Christopher Cunha. Samantha Cunha. Rachel Cunningham. April Zepiel. Maya Lynn Davis. Mia DeCumber. Riley DeCumber. Dylan DeNaples. Tyler DeNaples. William Donnelly.
Owen Dudzik. Angelina DuPont. Sophia Emma. Richard Earhart. Julian Ivanchik. Colleen Fahey. Victoria Falzarano. Ryan Foley. Rebecca Forrest. Alexander Frame. Brianna Garcia. Gunnar Jenberg. Daniel Germansky. Paige Germansky. Mackenzie Glenn. Raymond Getz. Jacob Goldbeck. Aaron Goldberg. Abigail Gohl. Victoria Gomez. Richard Gonzalez. Timothy Griffin. Ava Guardino. Edali Gutierrez. Megan Hall. Lena Hemday. John Handel. Devin Hernandez. Jacqueline Hernandez Pezos. Jocelyn Hernandez Pezos. Madeline Hill. Kelly Hennigan. Michael Horgan. Aiden Hikowski. Andrew Heisers. William Hyde.
John Iglar. Eliessa Istreffi. Dominic Giosi. Emma Young. Ethan Karate. Evan Karate. Braden Kelly. Rachel Knopf. Elizabeth Less. Jacob Legas. Aiden Lindgren. Rebecca Lombardi. Mason Longo. Sophia Lucianen. Anna Lungu. Derek Luttenberger. Caitlin McSweeney. Nathaniel Moriello. Olivia McCory. Thomas McDevitt. Martin McGill. Luke McGrory. Katrina McMahon. Giselle Melgar. Kendra Meyer. Mackenzie Minervini. Michaela Moen. Layla Moremi. Maya Nash. Jason O'Brien. Alexandra Ortega. Muriel Osmansky. Shayla Osmansky. Daniel Palazzo. Jake Petticone. Madeline Petruska.
Liam Philhauer. Yassine Rashid. Miran Redzepi. Andrew Rivera. Nicholas Rodriguez. Allison Romeo. Noah Rosario. Arian Selyowski.
Angelica Santiago. Alyssa Savastano. Alexa Schickman. Amanda Shore. Hannah Sisler. Brian Soperanis. Tyler Spear. Adam Staniback. Hannah Steigerwall. Alyssa Strapoli. Brandon Sutherland. Anthony Tomorrow. Kyle Tedesco. Jessica Tennyson. Jake Tenor. Alexander Tops. Ryan Teresi. John Towie. Ryan Trokolar. Patrick Unger. Addison Van Lenten. Alexander Van Varick. Chloe Vasquez. Kiara Velasquez Peleas. Jovan Vinas. Mia Walker. Adam Watson. Matthew Weir. Frank Weiss. Javed Yassin. Sophia Zaccaro. Ava Zoda.
We'd like to thank the faculty and staff for their unwavering support during our 3 years here at Pequannock Valley School. We have learned so much, and this will greatly benefit us as we begin the next phase of our educational journey, high school. Of course, the past few months have been particularly challenging, and we want to say an extra thank you to our teachers and the school staff for the commitment, resilience, and creativity they have demonstrated in instructing us through distance learning. We will never forget these final few months of the 2019-2020 school year, and we couldn't have reached graduation without the help of all those at PV who guided our way.
Good evening, Mr. Portis, Dr. Winning, Mr. Sabrowski, Ms. Riggin,
members of the Board of Education, Pequannock Administration, PV faculty and staff, parents, family members, and most importantly, the PV class of 2020. Here we are at the climax of our most recent chapter. This graduation day is very special because we are celebrating our graduation from middle school as we move up to the high school in September. Every year, we move a step closer on our path to adulthood. We all remember our first day as sixth graders with many things to get used to, switching classes, opening our lockers, changing into gym clothes, and most of all, trying to remember if it was a day one or a day two. We had heard that the best food is served at PVMS, so we just had to make it to lunchtime and everything would be okay. By seventh grade, we had gained more independence and responsibility. We learned to take pride in our work and our actions. We became more comfortable asking questions if we didn't understand the subject, adapted to new challenges, and for the first time, figured out how to help ourselves. We advocated for ourselves and succeeded in becoming more positive with each day. Finally, as eighth graders, we became the leaders of our school. We became more mature, and our crucial role was to help and support the younger students and to lead by example. Even though we did not end the school year as expected, we still made the best of it. On a positive note, we made history through remote learning. Yes, there were challenges, but the staff and students worked together to make it happen. Although we are not able to have our breakfast, our last sorority park trip, our last field day, our formal and our graduation like we normally would have, we will forever cherish our PV memories such as pep rallies, our two field days, our two sorority park trips, time spent with our friends during lunch, sports and clubs, bus rides, house days, and the one we cannot forget, the health class pet project. Even though the conclusion to our eighth grade year is slightly different than what we are used to, we are ready to take the next step. As Dr. Seuss once said, we're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. We all have amazing futures ahead of us, which will present us with great opportunities. It is what we do with these opportunities that count. Before I close, I would like to point out that our graduation would not have been possible without the help, courage, guidance, dedication, and support from our outstanding PV staff. On behalf of the class of 2020, we would like to thank our principal, Mr. Sabarowski, our assistant principal, Ms. Riggin, and the fantastic and intelligent teachers, counselors, advisors, and coaches. Our success is also your success, and we thank you for your dedication to what comes next in our lives. Mr. Sabarowski, we will miss your positive energy, the depth of your knowledge, and your encouraging spirit and promise. You truly display what it means to be a Panther and have helped prepare us for the thrilling road ahead. I would like to acknowledge our new and old friends, our families, and our incredible parents for their love and support. Congratulations to the graduates of 2020. The finish line we crossed tonight is a starting line to what comes next on our high school journey. There are so many thrilling things ahead. Thank you and have a good night.
Well, you finally made it. Each and every one of us is extremely proud of all the hard work and dedication you put into our classes. While we can't be there in person, we want to wish you the best of luck as you embark on your new adventures in high school. Trust in knowing that you have what it takes to be successful and that you are ready for this next chapter. Congratulations, and know that each one of us wishes you and your family a safe and memorable summer.
To the class of 2020, your teachers have had the privilege of watching you grow into intellectual young adults. Spirit, knowledge, pride, and wisdom will follow you throughout your entire career. We look forward to hearing about all of your future successes. Leave your footprint on the world and know we are so proud of you. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Hey, graduates of PV School. That's what we're going to call you now. This is Mr. Slaff, and I'm speaking to you on behalf of the entire math department at PV School. We just want to let you know how proud we are of what you guys have accomplished and the accolades you guys have earned over the 3 years at PV School. We know that when you get to the high school, you are going to make us proud.
Congratulations, 8th grade. Mr. Foth and I are so proud of all of your academic and music accomplishments this year and always. Remember to keep playing your instruments and singing. We can't wait to hear about how awesome you are in high school and beyond. And remember, music expresses that which cannot be said and on which it is impossible to be silent. Congratulations.
To the graduates, on behalf of the PE department, we would like to wish you nothing but happiness and success in your future endeavors. And in the words of Jimmy Valvano, don't give up, don't ever give up. We will always be here for you. If you ever need anything, we are just a phone call away or stop by and see us at the middle school.
Good evening, everyone. This is Mr. Kopp representing the PV Science Department. It is with great pride that we congratulate the class of 2020. The PV Science Department encourages you to stay curious, question everything, and seek the truth. You may be more prepared for high school than any other class that has graduated from PV. You've shown great integrity, adaptability, and resilience. Your work ethic, attitude, and attendance has been superior. For all of these qualities, we say thank you, good luck, and congratulations. You deserve it.
On behalf of the PV Social Studies Department, we would like to wish you the best of luck in high school and your future.
Our country's future is brighter because of you. Thank you, good luck, and do not forget to visit.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We would like to wish you the best of luck and success in high school. Study hard, get involved, volunteer to help others, and be true to yourself. We'd like to leave you with these words by Douglas MacArthur. A true leader has the confidence to stand alone, the courage to make decisions, and the compassion to listen to the needs of others.
If you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. If you talk to him in his own language, that goes to his heart. Nelson Mandela. On behalf of the PV World Language Department, it has been a true pleasure teaching all of you, and we want to thank you for your hard work over the past few years. Never stop learning different languages. They will bring you great opportunities, and we hope that you will be able to apply them throughout your lives. Congratulations on your graduation and good luck in all that you do.
Felicitaciones por su graduación y buena suerte en todo lo que hagan.
Bear with me on the French.
Felicitaciones pour votre diplôme et bonne chance dans tout ce que vous faites.
On behalf of the Pequannock Township School District Supervisors, I want to take this opportunity to congratulate our 8th grade students on their graduation. We're so excited to see you move on to high school and watch you grow and learn as part of our Pequannock Township High School. Congratulations.
On behalf of the PV administration, we say congratulations. We hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. Your futures are so extremely bright. We are so proud of you. You will forever have a home here at PV. And remember, anything is possible when you just believe in yourselves. Good luck and congratulations.
Hey, congratulations, Pequannock Valley School Class of 2020. It is an honor to have worked with you your first 2 years of PV school, and now to see you graduating, way to go. All that hard work and dedication really pays off. And you know what? Here's your next stop. There's a world of opportunity waiting inside these doors for you to continue to learn, to grow, to challenge yourself. And I can't wait to work with you over these next 4 years. So why don't you come inside and see what Panther Pride is all about. Congratulations. Let's go, Panthers. Come on, let's go. Come on, come on.